So remember the lunatic that was supposed to turn over the election wave for Donald Trump, and it was going to be, quote, biblical? Yeah, that kook's name was Sidney Powell. She somehow is a practicing licensed attorney, and she was making up all these insane conspiracy theories. The conspiracies were that the Dominion voting systems were flipping the votes, either because of the algorithm or it was funded by Venezuela and, you know, the dead Hugo Chavez or whatever. Just insane, crazy stuff, right? And the Trump legal team had chosen her as part of their legal team in a tweet, but then had to distance themselves because she started to split Republicans up by choosing different Republicans than Kelly Loeffler. So they had to distance themselves from her. So as the Dominion voting systems have sort of been under fire as, you know, supposedly flipping the votes and yada yada, a lot of people are wondering, hey, why don't they file a defamation suit? They should file a defamation suit. Well, the defamation suit is here. It says Dominion Voting Systems files $1.3 billion defamation lawsuit against pro-Trump lawyer Sidney Powell. So it says Dominion Voting Systems on Friday filed a defamation lawsuit against pro-Trump lawyer Sidney Powell for claiming without evidence that the voting machine company rigged the 2020 presidential election for President-elect Joe Biden by manipulating votes. Dominion is seeking $1.3 billion in damages and an order from the court for Powell to cease making false statements about it. Quote, the recent attacks on the democratic process are not singular or isolated events, Dominion CEO John Poulos said in a call with reporters Friday morning. They are the result of a deliberate and malicious campaign of lies over many months. Sidney Powell and others created and disseminated these lies, assisted and amplified by a range of media platforms. Lies were told about government election officials, election workers, and Dominion voting systems. Those lies have consequences. They have served to diminish the credibility of U.S. elections. They have subjected officials and Dominion employees to harassment and death threats. They have severely damaged the reputation of our company. Today is just the first step to restore our good name and faith in elections by holding those responsible to account. So this is definitely something that is certainly very, very important, actually, and it's something I've kind of been talking about the past couple of videos about the potential for the Trump attorneys like Rudy Giuliani, Lynn Wood, Sidney Powell to actually be sanctioned and to be punished because they're not following ethics violations by bringing up a bunch of frivolous lawsuits that are completely meritless. And so the last one, the federal judge was saying they might be punished. And the issue here is they've really gone through all of this bullshit without any of them being punished, right? Trump is finally starting to be punished in a certain way. You guys saw that his Twitter account finally got suspended, right? That probably means more to him than anything else in the world is his Twitter account, right? But these people have been able to go through all these steps without facing any punishments. So the attorneys are able to bullshit their way through without any punishments. No, not being disbarred and, you know, being given fines, which is what the court should be giving to these people like Rudy Giuliani. And so this is really good because, you know, you go to court. Hey, if you can prove your allegations of the funding or that it's flipping votes, all this crazy shit that Sidney Powell has been claiming, well, hey, then you win, right? But, you know, otherwise you should get sued for defamation because you did do insane amounts of damage, not really only to the U.S. election system, but obviously to Dominion voting systems as well as just the election as a whole, right? And it does cause a lot of potentially irreparable damage, which if they are based on lies, that is certainly a suable offense, right? You can't lie about somebody or a company or something like that, do damage based on lies. It's not a legal thing. You can't do that. So it's $1.3 billion. Obviously, they're not going to be able to get that out of them. It's a huge, 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 huge number. That's a huge defamation lawsuit. I have no idea how this court proceeding is going to go forward. I don't know if it's even going to go to trial or not. A lot of these cases are just settled outside of court. So I'm not really sure how this is going to go. But this is good because, you know, legally they can clear their name and then everybody knows that Sidney Powell is a bullshit artist. But it's important for these punishments to actually be handed out. So Trump going to prison for his crimes. Obviously, he's lost the election, which is one of the punishments. Now he's banned from Twitter. Hopefully, he goes to prison for his crimes. You know, the attorneys who have been having these, bogus legal cases, they should be disbarred as well as facing fines. And yes, this kind of a, defamation suit is very, very important. Because if there are no punishments for this kind of behavior, they're just going to do it again. They're going to continue to do it, and it makes a mockery of your system. So there does need to be these kinds of punishments handed out. It is absolutely vital and crucial.